Hey, I'm Josh Pigman.
This is Josh.
This is Brian. Brian, question. Yeah. Do you know if the rotationally invariant galaxy imaging thing that they did, do you know if there's a version of that in Keras? Or how we might build it in Keras?
There is not. It was a custom thing. So they took the center of the galaxy and they moved it to a corner.
Right.
And then they rotated it.
Right.
So there is data augmentation.
Yeah, so that I know how to do, but what I don't know how to do is build the 16-way network that then performs. Do you know how, do you have any thoughts about how I might do that?
16-way network.
Right, because it's like, it's 16, but it's a network for each of the, maybe it's eight, for each of the rotations of the network that then comes together to a single.
Oh, you can have multiple, you can do multi-tail or multi-input networks. That's possible.
Yeah, so.
You know, there's like a merge function.
Right, because I think, so cutting up the galaxies that feel comfortable to me, it's that kind of basically reproducing the network in Keras.
I'm sure if it's all about saying here, like, all
right,
there you go. Right. There are those features, and you can do that, and you can use that.
Okay, cool. So I think that'll be useful. I don't care that much in this particular hack about, you know, using my rock curve. I want to just show that it's possible. But I do want to get a sense, like, if I'm doing this color reaction, I want to see how good we can do. Because if it's like, well, you can do really badly, then it's not that interesting. So
we're going to a failure point.
I want to get to some point where I'm like, okay, this is either possible or I think we need to do that.
Sure. Yeah. That'd be awesome.
Thanks.